Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We're glad to have each and every one of you on this beautiful Sunday morning as we gather together to worship the Lord. We gather together as God's wonderful people to lift up the name of Jesus Christ, that name is above all names. At his name, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We gather together to fellowship one with another. We gather this morning to pray for one another, to pray for this nation, to pray for God's intervention in all that's going on in the world around about us. We pray for one another in a very special way. We gather together to worship the Lord. We gather together as we make that difference in one another's lives. Hymn number 144, This Is My Father's World. This morning, as we go to the Lord in prayer, we want to continue to remember all those that are in need of God's touch. We ask the Lord to be with each and every one of them in a mighty way. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we come before your throne of grace this morning, Heavenly Father, though the evil seems so great and the wrong is so abundant, Lord, we know that you're still ruler of all. We know that you have complete control. And Lord, we look to you for answers. Lord, we live in a chaotic time where a virus is sweeping over the nation, where chaos is spreading from one city to another. Lord, we don't have the answers, but you do, Lord. And we know that it's in your Son, Jesus Christ. And there is no other hope but through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask for your presence today in each and every one of our hearts. Lord, we thank you for your love and your concern for each and every one of your precious children. Lord, we thank you for your goodness and for your mercy. Lord, you have been so good to your people. You have walked with us. You have been there when we needed you. Lord, we just thank you for who you are and what you continue to do for each and every one of us. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, and we thank you for what he did for us on Calvary's cross through his shed blood. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the hope that he gives unto each and every one of us. We thank you for life and life abundantly. We thank you for that assurance of eternal life. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your precious Holy Spirit that comes to live and dwell in each and every one of our hearts, to change us, to help us to be the children of the light rather than the children of the darkness. Heavenly Father, help us to walk in the light as you are in the light. Heavenly Father, we pray for all those that are sick, all those that need your touch this morning. Heavenly Father, we pray for this nation that is in chaos. Heavenly Father, we pray that your touch might be in the midst of every heart. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every one of these precious lives that have come this morning. Lord, you know each and every one of our hearts. You know everything about us. You know even the hair on our head and what number falls to the ground. For each and every one of them is numbered. Lord, we ask for that special touch as you meet each and every one of our needs today. And Heavenly Father, we ask that your Holy Spirit might come and dwell in each and every one of our hearts, and that your Holy Spirit might go with us throughout this service, that everything that's said and everything is done will bring glory and honor to your holy name. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, and for the prayer that he prayed on many occasions. He taught his disciples to pray, and we pray this morning as your children. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Hymn number 454, Open My Eyes That I May See. Our Psalter reading is found on page 854. As we read the second half of Psalm 139, beginning with verse 13. For it was you who formed my inward parts. I praise you, for you are fearful and wonderful. You know me very well. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. How profound to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! Oh, that you would slay the wicked, O God, and that the bloodthirsty would depart from me. Do I not hate them that hate you, O Lord? And do I not loathe them that rise up against you? Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. Way of announcements, we will continue to collect quarters for the memorial home through November, hoping that we'll be able to get there the 1st of December. Right now, we don't know what the situation might be, and so we will collect the quarters, and we will see that they will get the quarters. And then we will continue not to have any of our events until the situation gets better. We're thankful that we can gather together here on Sunday morning and worship, but rather than take a chance of having something go wrong with a fellowship, then we will continue to do away with our fellowship meals and until things are better. We pray that things will be better for long. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we realize without the gifts of the people, the church cannot be the church that you would have us to be. Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every gift that is given. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every person that continues to give, that this church might continue to remain the light in the darkness on the hill, Lord, that we might make a difference in this community. Heavenly Father, continue to bless each and every one that continues to give. Bless them in a mighty way. And use your gift for the uplifting of the kingdom of God. We ask it in that wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Would you stand for the doxology? 13th chapter of the Gospel of Matthew, verses 31 through 33, Jesus told them another parable. For the kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his field. Though it is the smallest of all seed, yet when it grows, it is the largest of the garden plants and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and build their nest in the branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed into a large amount of flour until it works all through the dough. Verses 44, the kingdom of heaven is like treasures hidden in a field. When a man finds it, he hid it again, and then in joy went and sold all that he had, and he bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for a goodly pearl. When he finds one of the great values, he goes away and he sells everything that he has and he buys it. Once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, the fishermen pulled it up on the shore, and they sat down and collected the good fish in their basket, but they threw the bad ones away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. For the angels will come, and they will separate the wicked from the righteous, and they will be thrown into the fiery furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And Jesus said unto the disciples, have you understood all these things? And they answered and said, yes. And Jesus said to them, therefore, every teacher of the law who has been instructed about the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old. And when Jesus had finished these parables, he departed from that area. The word of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, once again, we thank you for this scripture and for the message that you have given unto me as I break bread of life unto your wonderful people. Heavenly Father, may every word that flow from my lips be pleasing unto you. And Heavenly Father, these your precious children who have come today to hear the bread of life. Heavenly Father, may their hearts and meditation thereof be pleasing unto you. Lord, we ask for your precious Holy Spirit to come and to anoint each and every word that is spoken and each and every word that is received. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Our subject this morning is there is a beginning and there is an ending. We are a lot closer to the end than we are at the beginning. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The Spirit of God moved upon the face of the earth, and the earth was created. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and everything that was made by God, and there was nothing that was made that was not made by God. And Jesus Christ was with God from the foundation of the world, and everything that was made by God. In our parable this morning, Jesus says that the tiny mustard seed, the little tiny seed, was planted in a field, and it grew more than just a bush. It grew to be a tree that the birds were able to come and to build their nest in that mustard seed tree. A very unusual situation for a little tiny seed to be able to grow such a big tree that the birds could come and build their nest in. But Jesus said that is the way it is with the kingdom of God. It began in a small way. Sin came into the world, and God had to deal with that sin. And how would God deal with that sin? He would send his son Jesus Christ into the world that the world might know God through him. And John would say, "Behold the Lamb of God who comes to take away the sins of the world." Jesus would begin his ministry in Capernaum, and he would stand before the people and read, "This is the acceptable year of the Lord. For I have come to set the captives free, to preach the gospel to the poor, that the blind might see, that the lame might walk, that the lepers might be cleansed. This is the acceptable year of the Lord." And Jesus would begin his ministry. And he would walk by the Sea of Galilee, and he would walk into the tax collector's office, and he would call those disciples from all walks of life, and he would say, "Follow me," and they would follow him. And Jesus would send those disciples out to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And at the end of his ministry, he would tell those disciples to go into all the world and preach and teach and baptize in my name, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The ministry would begin with Jesus, and Jesus then would call his disciples and he would send them out. And then the word would go forth. For Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is like a sower that goes out and he sows the seed. And the seed is the word of God. And the word of God will fall by the wayside. The word of God will fall upon the rocky soil. The word of God will fall among the thorns and the thistles. But the word of God will also fall among the fertile soil, and it will bring forth 30, 60, and 100-fold, and the kingdom of God will continue to grow." He says the kingdom of God is like a man that goes out and plants good seed, and then the evil one comes and plants bad seed at night. And the good seed and the bad seed grows together. The wheat and the tares grow together. And you can't tell the difference until the fruit begins to appear. And the question is asked, do we pull up the weeds out of the wheat? And he said, let them grow together. God is the one that sends the word out. He sends it forth. And the children of the light is the good seed. And the children of darkness is the bad seed. Those that have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior is the children of the light. Those that have rejected Jesus Christ and has nothing to do with him is the children of darkness. And Jesus says there will be a day of judgment, just as it is with the wheat and tares, when they will be separated. So shall it be with him. Jesus said the kingdom of God is like that of leaven. When a woman puts the yeast in three pieces of bread, and eventually it takes over the whole batch. In the same way, you cannot see the yeast working, but you can see the results of it as the bread begins to rise. In the same way, the kingdom of God, as the Holy Spirit begins to work in each and every one of our lives, we cannot see the Spirit working, but we can see the results of the Spirit working. As Jesus is on the inside, moving on the outside, bringing about a change in our lives. Oh, what a change. Oh, what a change. Oh, what a change in our lives. When Jesus is on the inside, moving on the outside, bringing about that change in our lives. That's how the Holy Spirit works, moving within our lives, moving to help us to become a better person. He says the kingdom of God is like a treasure that is hidden in a field. And a person goes and finds that treasure, and he hides that treasure, and he goes and he sells everything that he has for the joy of it, to be able to have that treasure at the cross where I first met the Lord. At the cross where I first saw the light. And the light changed my heart. At the cross where I first saw the light. And the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight. I am happy all the days. And he walks with me and he talks with me. And he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. And we walk with me and he talks with me. And he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. The joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. You see, when Jesus Christ becomes Lord of our lives, there's joy. It doesn't make any difference about the outside circumstances, because Jesus Christ lives within us. And we have the joy of knowing that he will be with us and he will walk with us and he will talk with us and he will tell us we are his own. He says the kingdom of God is like a merchant that goes out and looks for that goodly pearl. And when he finally finds that pearl of great price, one that is perfect, he goes and he sells everything that he has and he purchases that pearl of great price. Well, this morning, Jesus Christ is the pearl of great price. And folks, we should be willing to give it all. Whatever it takes in order to know him in a personal way, for him to come and to live and dwell in our hearts, to walk with us, to talk with us, to tell us that he is our very own. We should be willing to pay whatever it takes, even to give ourselves totally and completely to him. He says the kingdom of God is like that of a dragnet. You see, in the day of Jesus, there was two different ways that they would fish. They would drop the net down into the ocean, and they would pull the net up, and whatever fish was in, they'd bring into the boat. Or either they would drag net. They'd take a big, wide net between two boats, and they would pull that net all the way from the ocean to the shoreline. And whatever fish was in there, they would divide the good and the evil. And Jesus said, that's the way the kingdom of God will be. There will be an ending when the time will come when the good and the evil will be separated. The angels will do the separating. And I believe today that God is looking down on this nation with a sad heart. He's looking at what is taking place in all of these different cities, Chicago, New York, Seattle, Portland, last night, Austin, Texas. You just keep adding and adding, and it's getting worse and worse. I believe that God is getting ready to call his children home. He's not going to continue to allow what's going on in these cities. And as we read in the scripture this morning, God knows everything about us. And God knows us even before we're born, while we're being made. There don't have to be a count for those people that are willing to kill the babies before they're born. There don't have to be a count for it. There's going to be a count for the people that make the law that allows this to happen. There's going to be a count for those little children, 1-year-old, 2-year-old, 3-year-old, 4-year-old, that is being shot in all these different cities. There's going to be accountability for what's going on in this world. The day is coming when the angels will separate the good from the evil. Jesus asked his disciples, do you understand these 7 parables? And they looked at him and said, yes. That's the question I asked you this morning. Do you understand these parables? Do you understand the parable of the sower? Do you understand the parable of the wheat and the tares? Do you understand the parable of the mustard seed and how it grows and how the kingdom of God grows? Do you understand how the yeast works and how the Holy Spirit comes to work in each and every one of our lives? Do you understand the joy of finding the treasure and knowing that Jesus Christ walks with us and talks with us, and he walks with us along the way, and he tells us that we are his? Do you understand about the pearl of great price? Are you willing to give it all for him? Are you willing to pay the price, whatever it might be, in order that Jesus Christ might become Lord of your life? And do you understand that there will be an ending as there was a beginning? And the angels will separate the good from the evil, from the children of the light and the children of darkness. The good seed is the children of light. The bad seed is the children of darkness. The one that loves us is the Lord. The one that is causing all the problem is Satan and evil. There is good and evil in this world. And each and every one of these parables helps us to understand the difference between that good and evil. Do you understand those parables this morning? Our closing hymn is 529, How Firm a Foundation, as we sing the first and last verse of 529. Heavenly Father, these are your precious children. You paid the price at Calvary's cross for each and every one of them. Heavenly Father, help us to understand your kingdom as we grow together as the family of God, as we make a difference in the world around about us, that there is love rather than hatred, that there is hope rather than despair, that there is the light rather than the darkness, and that we walk in that light as he is in that light, that we have that fellowship one with another. Heavenly Father, continue to watch over each and every one of us, to help us to understand that there is a day that's coming when God will bring home his children. Heavenly Father, watch over each and every one of us as you take care of us during these days. We ask it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.